immediately gets people listed in the state of mind of just like doing anything. So we'll start
there's some balancing there. There is yeah. right away.
Yeah, I think it's a really fun thing to do too.
Yeah, oh, it is. I like it. Wakes you up.
But you should, I'm sure I've mentioned this enough in class. When you're turning your back heel down in Warrior One, your hips are not going to be square. Mm-hmm. And if you have lower back problems, it could really compound them
to do
Warrior One really early in the sequence. Uh-huh. All right, so when your back heel is lifted, then the hips are completely square. And the pelvis is in much happier condition that way. So you're not straight.
So that's why you start with the hips a little.
That's why I start.
That's interesting.
Because it warms up, it gets the front of your hip open. Gets you all juiced up through here. Then you can begin to work on a Warrior One. With a little more accuracy and a little more warm up beforehand. It's much, much healthier for you.
What about teaching Warrior One with the back foot to the right of the front foot instead of.
You show me that.
So, like, I learned it like this instead of the Warrior Two position.
It's the exact same thing as Trikonasana. The alignment in classical Iyengar would be.
Heel.
Would be the
arch.
Center of the foot bisecting the arch, right?
Yeah.
Right. And for Warrior One, and then.